Alright, what is going on, guys? Fellows back again, coming at you with a showcase on the new Parasol Ikkaku. Now, I have been procrastinating this showcase because there's one thing that's really bugged me about this Ikkaku, and I'll get into it as we go over the skills. So shout out to my boy Leno for letting me do this showcase. And without further ado, let's just get right into it, right? So Ikkaku is going to be a Soul Reaper with a Human Killer. Human Killer kind of already upsets me because I feel like if a character has Human Killer or Quincy Killer or anything very obscure that's only good in like one or two guild quests, I prefer that character to have two killers just to make up for the fact that it's a very niche killer that doesn't really come into play all that often. And even though, don't get me wrong, I think that Human Killer for like content like IT can be relatively relevant, which is why I genuinely think that this character is pretty good. Pretty damn good, I should say, is he has the increased super heart link slot potions, increased heart link slot potions. We have the droplet drop. We have the pierce iron skin. So this character is literally made to pretty much combat IT. Now, what really bothers me with this character is they kind of like power creeped him a little bit and then they cucked him a lot. And by that, I mean, let's just take into account this character, right? This is the Ikkaku. He has, boom, boom. He has Frenzy plus 2. So this is going to be times 3 damage as like the base damage. He has a Berserker built in of 60%. The 80% here is because we're using the Lieutenant's Badge, right? So we're going to do this times 1.6. And then we're going to get a damage here times 1.3. For the damage to not afflicted by status element, 30% that he has, which is down here. Now, this is what bugs me. This increased damage to enemies not afflicted by an element, 30%. We recently got a... Not even recently. 8 months ago, we got Tensa Zangetsu. Now, Tensa Zangetsu got base damage of 100. Like let's just take... Let's compare the Ikkaku's base damage of 100 to Tensa's base damage of 100. Tensa got Berserker 60% as well. Now, he only got Frenzy plus 1. He didn't get Frenzy plus 2, so it's times 2 damage here, right? But what happened with Tensa is that K-Lab gave him damage to enemies not afflicted by status ailment plus 100%. Not 30%, plus 100%. And the reason that that's significant is that this, instead of going times 1.3, which would give him like 416 divided by 1.3, we're multiplying this by 2 because we're getting an extra 100% damage, which is literally times 2 damage. And you'll see here that this character goes to 640, right? This character goes to 640, and then we also, let's see here, times 1.3. So Ikkaku is already at 624, whereas Tensa is already at 640. Now, this isn't even taking into account that Tensa also has damage to melee damage plus 10%. And that gets him even higher than Ikkaku. So if we actually take Ikkaku's damage divided by 624, he's missing 13% damage on that Tensa. And that's not even taking into account the fact that if Tensa is taken into like a co-op quest, this 1.1 becomes 1.3. And then that also makes him significantly weaker than Tensa in IT co-op content, despite coming out 8 months later. Now, don't get me wrong. I don't think that every character should be OP. I don't think that power scaling should go way too out of control. But it's just so strange to me that K-Lab would make the conscious decision to give this character 30% increased damage to enemies not afflicted by an ailment when every single character released in the last 2 years that got this skill was 100% damage. I don't like that. And it's just like, it's kind of like inconsistent for inconsistent's sake. We've already gotten Frenzy plus 2 spiritual pressure boost 80% with the Rukia in this banner alone, right? So giving this character no status ailments and then just cucking him on damage just for the sake of like his bald head and maybe his bald balls. I don't get it. I don't get it. Without further ado, let's just get actually into the character. I just wanted to talk about it. I'm kind of rambling, I suppose. But it does irk me because I do like Ikkaku. I feel like every character would benefit from being good. It is what it is. Whatever. So let's just get into it. His utility skills, right? This character has Sprinter, Long Stride, Dodge Human Damage 50%, which is interesting, but can be very, very helpful for content like Guild Quest. Especially considering not even just guild quests. In content like IT, the human enemies are AIDS. Like, they suck. But in content like Guild Quest, where your multi-barriers are kind of like what are keeping these characters in the game, it's going to be pretty cool to see. I don't know how well he'll do in content like Guild Quest, but I wanted to bring it up anyways. He has a Berserker of 60%, Devastation 60%, so his Soul Bomb is going to hit pretty hard with the full stamina damage boost. Reduced Strong Attack cooldown 50%. Normally it's going to be 12%, but with the Strong Attack Recharge links that we're using full Strong Attack Recharge, full stamina damage boost links. We have Super Potions, regular potions, Droplet Drop 30%. No guaranteed droplet drop, where it's just like a static number, which is kind of sad. I feel like that could have been really cool. Havoc 20%, so increase Strong Attack radius. Frenzy plus 2, really, 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 really good, especially considering this character got Pierce Iron Skin. If you didn't get Pierce Iron Skin, this character would actually be Dog Water. Weakened defense from the T15 skill. I don't believe he has weakened defense naturally. We have Guard Break, hidden enemies, and the increased damage to enemies not afflicted by an ailment 30%. It's such a strange skill. I know that we got some Resurrection characters that got the increased damage to no status ailment. I believe it was... Oh, never mind. You got damage with the full stamp. Did you really not get it? Who got that skill, bro? Oh, it might have been Nemu. I believe it was Nemu. Yeah, there it is. Increased damage to enemies not afflicted by an ailment, 16%. She got it as a soul trait. I forget who else. I know that someone else got it, but I'm not going to lie. I don't really want to waste too much time looking around. But 30% just seems ridiculously low for a character that's been released in 2023, almost 2024. Considering we got freaking Frenzy plus 3 Ichigo, Tensa with the damage as if he had Frenzy plus 3, thanks to the Frenzy plus 1 times 2 damage, which is ridiculous. So, yeah, I mean, there's that. So, without further ado, let's take him into IT, see how he does there. Keep in mind that he will be dealing times 5 damage thanks to the Pierce Iron Skin. Oh, man, I do like Balgo. I know that he's fallen off quite a bit, but I really do like Balgo and the Ulquiorra. So, lunge first strong attack. I believe that's a beam second strong attack. Full screen third. And I'll test the beam from here. 100% beam. 100% of beam. All right, we have hidden enemies. I do like that. 1, 2, 1, 2. I always like long stride. I kind of wish this character got something else instead of a lunge. I feel like lunges have unfortunately kind of died. I love his special move animation. So this is like the main reason why I dislike the fact that he got a 30% damage to no status ailment enemies, because this damage to enemies not inflicted by a status ailment, I'm sorry, it's a mouthful, it is what it is, that's the skill name, I'm sorry, it affects your Soul Bomb damage. And that's why characters like Thousand Year Blood War, renewed anime Ichigo, is so damn good. Like, and he's fast, he's a nuker. He might not have the amount of hits as a bombardment unit, but he has the damage. Tensa Zangetsu, he got the damage. As long as like the enemies don't get hit with the status ailment. Weakened defense is not considered a status ailment, by the way. I should just make note of that. So yeah, I mean, it is what it is. It's a personal complaint. I don't know, I sound like a whiny little bitch. It is what it is. Let's just take him into IZ. Let's calculate his damage. Fortunately, without status ailments, he's super, super easy. It's kind of just like, what's the number? Multiply it, right? Frenzy plus 2. Oh, man. I remember it was crazy when a character got Frenzy in the first place. Oh, my God, I'm so old. Should be like 20k. Yeah, it's like 20k. Look at that. Yeah, so 20k if you had Killer. Through 32k, pretty standard. First strong attack hits 4 times. Oh, excuse me. First strong attack hits 6 times, which means... This is what I get for, like, taking my hand off the controller and starting to wave my hand around. Let's see here. 32k, first hit normally is 4 hits, but since he has Frenzy plus 2, it's 6. Wait, no, that's a lie. It's normally 3 hits... And with Frenzy, it's 6. with Frenzy plus 2, it's 9. There we go. So this is going to hit 9 times. At 32k with Killer, this is actually going to hit for roughly 32 times 9, 320,000 minus 32,000. 288,000 with the first strong attack. That's what I'm talking about. Like, it's not really, it's not good, it's not great damage. It's good damage, it's not great damage. And when you're talking about like characters released in 2023, where the content hasn't gotten, like this content hasn't gotten harder in literally, I don't even know since when. It's kind of upsetting to see like new characters that, in my opinion, their designs are freaking cool. Like look at this soul bomb, bro. You even got the music blasting in the background. It's a great special move animation. And he hits for 60,000, which means that we're gonna do 60,000, multiply that by 1.3 times 3 plus the initial 60,000. And then with Killer, like, so the 1.3 is the weakened defense. And then with Killer, we get 470k with the Soul Bomb. Not crazy special move damage, considering he has Devastation 60%. If he had that damage to enemies not afflicted by status ailment, this damage would be so much higher. Because, like, divided by 3, 1.3 times 2, 723,692. And, like, I get that he has a quote-unquote relatively high Devastation at 60%, but you know what? Tensa Zengetsu also has a devastation of 60%, and that's pretty much why I'm a little bit up in arms. To be fair, Tensa Zengetsu is one of my favorite characters to be released this year. I think that he's just an overall great character, but it pains me to see devastation 60%, frenzy plus 2, and then they decide increased damage to enemies not afflicted by ailment 30%. If it was 50% or 60%, I honestly couldn't complain, because that damage is still relative, like, relevant. And if you actually take the damage here, right, and you take the Akaku times 1.6 for the Berserker times 2, no, times 3 for the Frenzy plus 2 times 1.3, yeah, that's this 624. So if we divide this by 1.3 and then we multiply this by 2, you're hitting for 960, which should be literally exactly pretty much what this Tensa Zengetsu does minus the melee damage. And you'll see here the difference between like the 30% to 100% is literally just a night and day difference. Like, if we take the 624, was it 960 divided by 624, the damage difference is literally, you're missing out on like 54% damage because someone at KLab decided to spill their coffee on the keyboard and accidentally delete the 10 and replace it with the 3, you know? And it is what it is. Do I like the Akaku? I think he's all right. His kit, in my opinion, is not really all that great. A lunge first strong attack, a 3k link beam second. I'm sorry, 3k link beams nowadays, if there's a second strong attack, the cooldown on it is not good. It's just not. My bad, my cat's dropped something. Either way, it is what it is. I think he's a bit disappointing after I've played Rukia. I will say that I do like him a bit more than Gin, but I am very disappointed that KLab decided to give him 30% instead of 100%. I think it was a mistake. I don't know if KLab will patch that in later or if they'll retcon it. They usually don't. They kind of like to wallow in their mistakes and sweep it under the rug, just like their Uryu compensation, just like their Chronicle Quest compensation, just like their Kisuke Orb compensation from Safui. They kind of don't really... they don't take accountability for shit anymore. Back in the day, they used to. Nowadays, this KLab company, I don't know, man. Shout out to my homies that played the Utano Prince-sama, because apparently that game's getting shut down. Hopefully KLab's not going to shut down BBS. It's currently their only profitable IP. So, well, actually, Captain Tsubasa's doing good, but even Captain Tsubasa, they said that it's been going down a downtrend. But anyways, that's my overall thoughts when it comes to the Akaku. Pretty good. Kind of wish he was a bit better. I wish that they didn't nerf the damage. Anyways, I'm going to leave it at that. Stay blessed, y'all. You have a great one. See y'all. Next one. Peace.